Students, now once again, I present with you students. So today, we are going to discuss with you class 9th politics, and it is the lesson 5th, working up institution. So students, about this lesson, 2 video already I have made to you. It is the 3rd video of this chapter, students. So under this video, we will discuss these points. First, we try to understand about power of prime ministers, what is a coalition governments, the president, election of presidents. So students, in last video we have discussed many thing about Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, political executive, permanent executive, which types of executive has been present in our country, which types of system, members of the parliament, both houses. About these topics we have discussed in last video, students. That was second video. So in here we will try to understand about so many point. First, power of the prime minister. It is the main thing, power of the prime minister. So students, in here we can say, in our constitution, all main power has been given surely to the PM. PM can take decision main, which he decide, in generally any other person cannot oppose to that. But when we try to understand about constitutional matter, so students, in our constitution, any a specific responsibility have not decided to the PM. Any specific liability and work have not decided for PM in our constitutional under democratic matter. But dear students, Prime Minister is the head of parliament. Prime Minister is the head of cabinet. If cabinet try to take any decision, Prime Minister don't like that decision, any dispute may arise between ministry, the decision of Prime Minister to be last decision. That should not be changed by ministry or other places, you can say. If ministry distribute it also by the Prime Minister, PM will give the different type of ministry to the Lok Sabha Parliament MPs, and they redistribute also ministry to the MP. Our PM as a head, and he is all in all of the both houses. If any joint session is running on, presentation of PM is also very important to there. Joint session, about that already we have discussed. If any dispute may come between Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, that may come in joint session. That means any resolution has passed in Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha has rejected to that position, that times both house joints meeting may arranges. So students, this is the power of our PM, constitutional Indian democratic prime minister, that he can organize, he can understand, he can manage all of every country related matter or international matter also by the name of president. All every places in a written record, international treaty, international compromise, international agreement, all everything going to held by the name of president, by the PM. So students, this is the work, liability and responsibility of the Prime Minister in our country. Next point we will try to understand, व्हाट इज ए कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट. कोलिशन, कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट. ए गवर्नमेंट इफ एनी पार्टी कम अंडर द मेजोरिटी दे मेक द गवर्नमेंट. दिस गवर्नमेंट इज कॉल्ड वन पार्टी गवर्नमेंट. एंड इफ सम पार्टी कंबाइंड बिफोर इलेक्शन एंड फाइट इलेक्शन टू ईच अदर एंड आफ्टर विनिंग सम पार्टीज हैव गेट सम मेंबर्स, सम अदर पार्टी हैव गेट सम मेंबर्स एंड बो टू थ्री मोर देन 23. वन टाइम्स आवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर वाज एज अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, देयर वर 24 पार्टी कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट्स. इट इज द यूनिक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट्स. दे हैज मैनेज, दे हैज एस्टेब्लिश वेरी बेस्ट सिस्टम ऑफ कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन कोलिशन सम पार्टी ज्वाइन एंड कंबाइंड कंटेस्ट इलेक्शन. After election, they meet each other and all every party's contributions also to be under the governments. This is called as a coalition governments. In other word, you can say joint governments. In this government, some important fact also we should be try to understand, that students, PM is not so free. PM can not decision like that. In one party governments he can take decision. That means if any government has been only one party, for example present time your BJP governments, or before time many times was continue Congress governments also, PM can take decision as he wish. Some discussing before with their famous art of leaders, as he decide which he can take. But in coalition governments, he will have to discuss, he will have to try to convince to the other coalition party also. That means we want to take such types of action. This is will be good or not, you also suggest me. This is as a foundation of rights to PM, you can say. PM is not so free. All authority persons of governments will not be free under the coalition governments. They will have to take the permission. They will have to discuss to other coalition parties. After discussing only they can take the decision which all parties may agree on which matter, on which topic. So students, other topic which we are going to discuss with you, that is a precedent. Just we are telling to you about precedent. Precedent, as you know, PM is the head of our country. President is the head of state. President is all in all of your country, but in record, written power, President is the head of many places in many work. But maximum which has been power to the ministry, which has been power to handling the parliament, that is a PM. In here very important fact you will have to understand, election of the president. We try to understand in just we are discussing about prime minister. So student, in last video also we have told to you that prime minister is elected under the MP, by these MPs to concerning party which has won the election as a majority, and their representative is going to elect by the citizen, by the voters. But about president, president which has been elected by the member of Lok Sabha, member of assembly, assembly states assembly, these both place combined joint voting to be held and majority candidate to be elected as a president. Lok Sabha members will be vote to there, and assembly state assembly members also will give the vote to there. Combined voters were to be majority, that persons will be selected as a president of your country. This is the system of election of president. And just in here we can say prime minister. This is the also indirect elected by their representative, and president also as a indirect elected by their representative. But dear students, in here I have a major difference between PM and president elections. The election of president is surely to be given by the candidate, by the representative of the Lok Sabha and State Assembly. But about PM, it is the decision of majority, it is the decision of party who has win the election, who has come under the majority. The party will take the decision who is going to make as a PM, who will be as a PM. There has been no importance of vote of the MP. There has been no importance of vote. If any persons, very important fact, student understand this. If any person has not been the election of the MP, in here we should understand fact. MP, if person is a PM, they sure should be MP, member of parliament. But in here have some extra exception. Exception is this. Any persons who is a famous or special member of party, which party has been win, which party has come under the majority, and that persons have not win the election of MP, they also may be become as a prime minister. But students, after becoming the minister, prime minister, under 6 months he will win the as a MP. In any place he will have to win the as a MP, then he will be as a member of parliament, as a and prime ministers. That means prime minister will sure member of parliament also. But like this, any condition is not going to apply by the president. So students, this was point which we have discussed now. So it is the third video of this lesson about working of institution. Many type of institution we are discussing. Your cabinet is also as a best institution. All cabinet is as a institution. Lok Sabha, both houses of Lok Sabha, in your state assembly election, Vidhan Sabha, Vidhan Parishad, it is the very important fact, students. All is a institution, but Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad, about that we try to discuss some in shortly. So students, as a in parliament, both House as a lower house and upper house present Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha, such as in assembly election, in state election, state assembly election, Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad also has been present, which is as a lower house and upper house. Same as was in the Lok Sabha, lower house and upper house. That means to there Lok Sabha is the lower house and Raj Sabha is the upper house. Such as in state assembly elections, Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad, Vidhan Sabha is the lower house, Vidhan Parishad is the upper house. Vidhan Sabha members which elected by the voters, and Vidhan Parishad members which elected by the some members who has been elected by voters. For example, you can say who is a representative. This condition was applied under the Lok Sabha also. In Lok Sabha have a two house. In Vidhan Sabha, Vidhan Mandal, which you can say combined as a Vidhan Parishad and Vidhan Sabha. So students, this was the some facts related to this lesson, working of institutions. And students, it is the third video, and next point we will try to discuss in other video, fourth video. So students, थैंक यू वेरी मच स्टूडेंट्स, एंड स्टूडेंट्स इफ यू लाइक टू आवर वीडियो, इफ यू फील देयर हैज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट, यू अंडरस्टैंड मेनी थिंग अंडर दिस वीडियो, सो स्टूडेंट्स लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब दिस वीडियो एंड चैनल स्टूडेंट्स. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक्स.